The future of robotics is getting closer every day. Researchers around the world are hard at work creating better drone aircrafts. They're also hard at work building better humanoid robots. Now, they're also working on combining those technologies to create a humanoid robot that flies. Meet the Iron Cub.
Yeah, I can fly.
Iron Cub gives off more than a little Iron Man vibe. It has four jet engines, and its shiny silver pants were used to prevent the robot from setting its legs on fire. Eventually, those pants were replaced by flame-resistant plates to protect all of the robot's mechanical innards. Iron Cub was created by researchers at the Center for Robotics and Intelligent Systems at the Italian Institute of Technology. One of the key aims for this project is making robotic aerial manipulation more robust and energy efficient than ever before.
We don't come from the future, but that is where we are headed.
As explained by Daniele Pucci, head of the Artificial and Mechanical Intelligence Lab at the Institute, the current most common solution for aerial manipulation is a quad-rotor aircraft fitted with a robotic arm. Robots of that type cannot move around the environment utilizing contact forces, and they typically struggle to fly in windy conditions while manipulating objects. Pucci believes a humanoid robot could be easier to control thanks to a contact point between the robot and the environment, and that humanoid robots could be a testbed for flying exoskeletons for humans. Humans have long dreamt of flying without having to get inside an aircraft. There would be several uses for exoskeletons to allow humans to fly around the environment, including making travel and commuting easier. Exoskeletons allowing humans to fly could also have military applications. Pucci and other researchers on the project admit there is a long road ahead of them, but that they hope Iron Cub will be able to conduct controlled flights soon. Numerous hurdles still have to be overcome, including creating a general control framework. That control framework would have to include manipulation, contact locomotion, and flight. The team also has to determine how and when to activate the jets when the robot is walking. The team needs to determine at what walking speed it is more energetically convenient to turn the auxiliary jetpack on. Researchers also have to develop a way to deal with landing impacts to allow for a decent transition from flight to walking. Judging by the flame-resistant materials needed for the robot's body, the team also has to figure out how to prevent the robot from being damaged by the flames produced by the jet engines. While there are similarities between the fictional Tony Stark Iron Man suit and Iron Cub, there are some significant differences. Iron Man doesn't rely on a jetpack on his back. Rather, his suit has jets on its hands and feet. Iron Cub, by contrast, has small jet engines in place of hands and a twin-engine jetpack on its back. Iron Cub seems to be a combination of Iron Man and the Rocketeer. Considerable effort is being put into robotics research all around the world. For example, a company called Engineered Arts has developed what it calls an artificial body. The goal of the artificial body is to give artificial intelligence a physical body in which it can reside. Engineered Arts created a robot called Amica and designed it to support advanced movement, natural gestures, and intelligent interaction. The developers behind the robot also designed Amica to be cloud-managed with an API development kit. The robot is also modular, allowing it to be upgraded as technology advances in the future. The current version of Amica can't walk, but the company says it will walk eventually. Its modular design will allow robots in the field to be upgraded. The medical field has also seen significant scientific breakthroughs in robotics in recent years. Researchers have even been working on tiny robots that can be filled with drugs and introduced into the bloodstream.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, Rust. They're like a million tiny doctors who are always on call. You just drive them any way you want in the body, see?
The goal is to take powerful drugs for fighting diseases like cancer and deliver them directly to the target cells, helping them to eliminate some of the systemic side effects of powerful cancer medications. In this research, the scientists developed shape-changing microbots, guided using magnets outside the body to a specific location inside the body. The robots were designed to change shape in response to lower pH, because tumors are acidic. The first of these microbots were designed utilizing the shapes of animals, including fish, crabs, or butterflies, each with their own special features and abilities uniquely suited to their form.
Where'd that come from?
It's nanotech, you like it?
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more SlashGear videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.